Hello, my beautiful ladies. It's Greta here, Ladies Relationship Coach. And today, my queens, the topic for you is, should you have where is this going conversation with your man? So a lot of ladies get very impatient and we want relationship so soon. Usually ladies who want relationship really fast, first either we have the wrong idea about the guy, like we don't even know the guy, but he has charmed them so well and we have this fantasy about him and we think like, oh my God, this guy is amazing. I want to be in a relationship with him now, soon. And we get very, very impatient. So we go on a couple of dates, like a week, 2 weeks, and we go like, oh my God, I want him to be my boyfriend. Other ladies are actually so desperate that we agree to be in a relationship on the first date. Ladies, you don't even know that guy. He's trying to impress you so you would like him. The first month is just that. Right? So you don't even know the guy. Ladies, if you want to be happy in a happy relationship, you need to look at things logically. First is just charms, it's flattery, it's promises. It's the fantasy that you are creating about the guy in your head. There is no reality. Same as if you would have a friend, right? Let's say you see that friend, you bond, you click, and you think like, oh, what an amazing friend I have. 3 months later, 6 months later, some things are coming out and you're like, oh, that's not what I signed up for in this friendship. So the same goes with the guy. In order to know, is he a good boyfriend material, you need to get to know him by dating him for a while. If you want to have a conversation with him, where is this going? I'm gonna give you 3 reasons on why not to do that. Ladies, it will not speed things up. Women who start the where is this going conversation, they think, oh my God, maybe he's just so shy, ask me to be his girlfriend, or maybe he's so scared that I'm gonna say no, so I'm gonna ask him, or maybe he's just playing me, or maybe he's using me and I don't know what's happening, so I need to know. Please, if you are asking a guy, where is this going, after a week or 2 weeks, he doesn't know it himself because he doesn't know you yet. Because he doesn't know, are you a girlfriend material yet or not? So what is the point to ask him? He will tell you, I don't know, let's take things slow. And you will also come across as a pursuer, which will turn him off. At the same time, you will come across as a woman who really wants to be in a relationship, even though you don't even know the guy yet. Therefore, your value in his eyes will go down because you're acting desperate. Okay, ladies, let a man do his job and wait for him to ask you to be his girlfriend. It's an amazing feeling when a guy does that because it makes you feel feminine and you as a receiver, you decide yes or no, you have a final decision. And a guy feels good as well. He is feeling his testosterone rush. He's coming across as a pursuer. He's acting as a prince. A guy loves to be a prince. He doesn't like to be a princess. Same as you like to be the receiver and be the princess. Ladies, don't rush things. Let a guy do his job and ask you to be his girlfriend. And if he's not asking you, don't put all the eggs in one basket. Date. You can date many people at the same time. You're not exclusive. You're not in a relationship. Date. Explore your options. That way you have nothing to lose. Second tip is a story when the guy is really taking it slow. And I have 2 examples of a similar story. And I'm going to share with 2 ladies where one lady acted high value and what has happened. And another lady acted low value and what has happened. Okay. So there was a story with this lady that she and this guy met and the guy started pursuing her and he has been asking her out for about 8 months. He was arranging the dates, he was paying for the dates, he would keep in touch as a friend every single day with her. He was giving a lot of mixed signals that we are dating. After about 8 or 9 months, the girl was like, I don't understand what is happening. He's giving so many signals that where are you, who are you with, what time are you coming home, are you meeting a boy or a girl for lunch. He is asking me out on the dates, he's paying for the dinner, he's treating me really nice. It seems like we are dating, but she says like, but he's not really asking me to date and he's not has asked me to be his girlfriend and he has not really made moves on me, but I'm developing feelings for him. So she decided, through thinking about that a lot, and after 8 months she decided, you know what, I'm gonna ask him. And she opened up, he asked her out as a friend, and she opened up to him and she said, look, I'm developing feelings for you and I don't understand, what is this? You know, are we dating? Are we not dating? Because, you know, and the guy got defensive and he says, oh, I don't have any feelings for you. And then the girl was very logical and she said, well, you actually been giving me a lot of mixed signals through your actions. This is why I picked it up like that. But then she said, it's fine. Don't worry about it. That's all cool. Thanks for sharing. Now I know that we are on the same page. So she handled the rejection in the most high value way possible. Then straight away, she put him into a friend zone, opened all of her options and literally acted him as a friend. No googly eyes, no like, I love you, none of that stuff, just really, really friend zoned that guy. After her friend zoning him like this, after 3 months, then he asked her out again as a friend. He courted her and asked her to be his girlfriend. Okay, so ladies, my point is, don't ask the guy, where is this going? If he's taking it really slow, what you do, you just keep all your options open, you date the other guys, you enjoy the moment, and you just go at his speed. If he's taking a year, fine, take a year. You're not wasting your time because you're keeping your other options open. If another guy comes in and he's much better and he's much more amazing and he sweeps you off your feet much faster and he's trying to make you into a girlfriend, that's great, you're gonna go with that guy. But if there is no one available, you keep dating him and you let him go at his speed. Starting the relationship talk first, it will not speed things up, it will only slow things down. And if you are high value and you get rejected, you, same as this girl, you will handle it really well. But now let me share another story with you ladies there. I have a client and this was the same kind of way that things has happened. And the guy was taking her out to romantic dinners, doing many things for her, introducing her to family and friends, sweeping her off her feet. And it was going on like this for ages, for 6 months or so. And she got influenced by someone else to start a conversation on what is this? Where is this going? Do you have any feelings for me? Do you see me as a girlfriend? The guy said to her, I told you we are just friends. And she got crushed. She got crushed and she reacted to that in a very needy way. She started acting needy. She started getting insecure. She started pursuing him. She lost her emotional control. And this has happened because she was not as logical or as strong as this girl right here. Or she has not handled the rejection well, right? But now she's gonna get her, however, now she's gonna get herself together and friend zone the guy too and start to act like a high value woman that she is. My point is, do not start these conversations. Where is this going? It's not your job to do that. It's a man's job. Let him do his job and just chill, be feminine, be a receiver and enjoy being the queen that you are. Third point that I would like to make, ladies, is do not let the outside influence your decisions or your actions towards the guy. There is a lot of very wrong dating and relationship examples out there, and we are influenced to make bad decisions probably majority of the time. So my point is, like, ladies, be very, very careful who you let into your life and who you let influence you. Because you are who you surround yourself with. If you are the only girl who is trying to be high value and you are surrounding yourself with low value friends or people who don't know where is the good advice, where is the bad advice, eventually you will get influenced by that, and then you will react on that, which will not benefit your relationship at all. You know, so ladies, be just very, very careful who you surrounding yourself with. Queens surround themselves with queens. If you want to be a queen, if you want to be high value, you need to surround yourself with other high value women. Otherwise, you will get influenced and you will start to react and your relationship will start to go down. Also, ladies, please watch my video, which is called Why You Should Not Tell Him How You Feel, which you can find just by following the link right here. So ladies, if you liked this video, please press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Join Greta's High Value Women School, where we are all in the same boat, learning how to be women of high value and bring out the best in our men. Follow me on my Instagram is private, it's called Ladies Relationship Coach. And if you would like some one-on-one coaching, please get in touch through my WhatsApp or just book me directly through my website and we will start. So thank you so much for watching, have a beautiful day, kisses from London. Mwah.